High above the Willamette Valley, one mountain rises like an island in the sky, a place where wind, stone, and memory converge. This is Mary's Peak. But before it was a summit, it was something else entirely. Long ago, where the Pacific Ocean now churns, molten rock spilled from the seafloor. It cooled, hardened, and sank, layer after layer. Then the earth began to move. Plates collided. Mountains rose. Deep underground, a coarse rock called gabbro formed, stubborn and strong. Millions of years later, that rock would emerge, high above the valleys, defying erosion, becoming a summit. Mary's Peak wasn't shaped overnight. It rose from the depths of geologic time. For the Kalapuya people, Mary's Peak was sacred. They called it Chatimanwi, the place of spiritual power. When floodwaters cover the valley, they climbed this mountain for safety. They came to hunt, to gather, to pray, and to heal. It was a place where the veil between worlds felt thin, a summit of survival and reverence. Then came the settlers, naming rivers, carving roads, and leaving their mark on the land. In 1845, Mary Lloyd crossed a river that begins on this very mountain. Her name was given to both the river and the peak, Mary's River, Mary's Peak. But long before that, the land already had a name and a story. In the late 1800s, a tiny town called Peak took shape on the mountain. Cabins, post office, even a ski tow. But the snow didn't last, and neither did the town. Then, in the 1940s, the Shriners brought thousands here each summer for celebration and fundraising. You can still find the old barbecue pits in the grass. In the Cold War era, Mary's Peak took on a new role, radar station. The Air Force built a tower to scan the skies for Soviet bombers. But before it could be activated, a storm ripped the antenna apart. The site was abandoned before it ever switched on. Today, two radio communication buildings remain at the summit, one operated by the Bonneville Power Administration, the other by the Forest Service. In 2011, a fence installation disturbed fragile summit soil. Native plants were bulldozed. Erosion took hold. The Forest Service pledged to restore it. And slowly, the wildflowers returned. Splashes of purple lupin and golden wallflower dancing in the wind. Today, Dr. Robert Lillie, geophysicist and author, walks these trails with visitors. With a model helmet and a pocket full of rocks, he tells the story of Mary's Peak, from seafloor basalt to mountain summit to cultural landmark. His hikes, offered through the Mary's Peak Alliance, are more than a walk through nature. They're a journey through time, and they remind us why this place matters. From the summit, the view stretches across eons, the Willamette Valley below, the Pacific on the horizon, the Cascade volcanoes rising like sentinels to the east. Mary's Peak isn't just a scenic overlook. It's a sacred mountain, a Cold War outpost, a floral sanctuary, a place where the earth still remembers. So walk its trails, read its rocks, and listen to the wind, because this mountain still tells its story.